we're going to be doing a beginner's yoga class. So to begin, sit up nice and tall with your legs crossed. You're welcome to use cushions under your knees to support your knees because some people's hips are a little more tight. Also, if you want, you can sit on a pillow just so that your pelvis is tilted forward. This is also good for the hips. All right, so please get yourself nice and comfortable. You can pause the video if you need to get your props. And when you're ready, let's meet back seated. We're going to place our hands on our knees. And just begin by closing our eyes. So make sure the spine is nice and tall. Take your shoulders, roll them up, take them back, and then let them go down just to open up our chest. Our chin is about parallel to the floor, so bring it down a little, most likely. And we'll begin just by breathing in deeply through the nose and exhaling through the mouth. Inhale deeply through the nose and through the mouth exhale. Just keep your eyes closed. Inhale through the nose and through the mouth exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, grow your spine nice and long. Exhale, relax your body. Inhale and exhale. This time I invite you to make a noise. Inhale and just sigh it out. Continue inhaling for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now hold the breath for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now exhale for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale deeply through the nose. 3, 4, 5. Hold the breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Through the mouth, exhale. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And inhale deeply, nose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold the breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Through the mouth, exhale. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale deeply, nose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Mouth exhale. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, nose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold the breath. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Through the mouth, exhale, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Inhale, nose, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Exhale, mouth, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And inhale normally. And exhale completely. Let's take our hands into prayer position in front of our heart and take a moment to set your intention. So what it is that you want to work on, what is it that you want to manifest in your life? Bring into your conscious awareness whatever it is that you want to lock and seal into your heart for this practice. let's just bow our head in reverence, honoring the beginning of this practice. And head up, bring your hands onto your knees. You can open your eyes. And we're going to begin warming up the body with some neck rolls. So we're just going to take the neck in big circular motions. And you can link the breath with this motion. Inhaling, the head goes back. Exhaling, the head goes down. Feeling a nice stretch all sides of the neck. Let's take it the other direction. Big circles in the opposite direction. Again, we can link our breath with the movement. Inhale, head goes back. Exhale, head comes forward. And then let's come to center. We're going to just place our hands in our hip crease, palm face down. Inhale, bring the shoulders up, and slowly exhale as you drop them. Inhale, we're taking nice big shoulder rolls. Forward, up, back, down. Forward, up, back, down. Really massage out those shoulders. Take it as slow as you need to really feel into your shoulders here. And then let's change directions. Take them back, up, forward, down. Good, and then we'll pause here. We're going to take our hands onto our knees, and we're going to take big circles with our upper body. Going all the way to the side, all the way forward as much as you can to the side. And then hollow the spine, and then keep coming around. You should feel stretches maybe on the side body as you come from side to side, in your hips. Go as slow as you need to go and really just take this as an opportunity to massage out. The word yoga means to unite with yourself. So this whole practice is about just bringing a deeper awareness to yourself. And it starts with the physical self, so we're bringing awareness to our physical bodies, how flexible we are, how open our joints are, how much fluid we have. And then let's take these circles in the opposite direction. So it's really a practice about mindfulness, about presence, how deeply can we just stay in this moment? And when we find the mind is running away thinking about what we're going to do for the rest of the day or tomorrow or what we did yesterday, we just bring a very intentional direction of the mind back to this moment. And the easiest way to do that is just to direct the mind to the flow of the breath. Last circle, and then come to center. Good, now we're going to place our left hand on the floor. We're going to pick up our right hand all the way up, stretch up, and then we're just gonna lean over to the left-hand side, feeling a nice side body stretch. If you wanna come a little bit deeper, you're welcome to come onto your forearm and then just open your chest to the sky here. Instead of hunching down, we're opening up like this. Breathe, feeling a nice deep side body stretch. The straighter you move your arm, the deeper the stretch will be. Awakening the body. And slowly come back up to center. We're going to switch sides. Again, if you want to come deep into your forearm, open up your chest, stretch the upper arm long. And breathe here. Open the chest, stretch that arm, feel the side body lengthen. Good, and then come back up to center. Lower the arm. Good, and just shake your body a little bit. Shake, 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 shake. Good, now we're gonna come to a position called tabletop. So we're gonna come onto our hands and knees. The hands are directly under the shoulders. The knees are placed under the hip. The knees are hip width apart. The shoulders are shoulder width apart. And now we're going to move into a position called cat-cow. We're going to inhale. We're going to look up and arch the back. Then we're going to exhale. We're going to round the spine. Push into the ground and look down. Inhale, look up. Exhale, round down. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Really firmly press into the ground. Continue here. And I invite you to just move at your own rhythm. This is a nice massage for the spine. So really emphasize the movement of the spine, the flexion. And again, connect to your breath. Inhale as you look up and exhale as you round down. You can go a little bit faster if you like, or slower, whatever it is that your body needs. Good. Now we're going to come back to tabletop, straight spine. And we're going to begin just by lifting our left leg up and back behind us. So the leg should be about parallel to the floor. I don't want you to open up your hip. I want to keep the hip square to the floor. And breathe here. Try and stay centered and use your core to help you stay here. And slowly bring that knee down. We're going to switch sides. We're going to bring the right leg up. Use your core. Hold strong. If you're having a hard time balancing here, you can look a couple feet in front of you, a few feet in front of you, and just stare at one point. It really helps with balance. And slowly bring that right leg down. We're going to go back to the left leg. Pick the left leg up. Breathe here. If you feel comfortable, give it a try and try and pick your right arm. Again, focus at that point. Use your core and breathe here. you fall out of it, you come back in and really try and balance. And let's break the pose. Hand down, knee down. Let's bring the right leg up. We'll start here. Remember, I don't want you to open the hip like this. I want the hip to stay square. And now pick up the left hand. Stay balanced. Find that point on the ground that's not moving and let it help you anchor. And make sure the right arm is strong and straight. You're not dumping into it. And slowly hand down, knee down. Good. And now we're going to come to a position called downward facing dog. We're going to curl our toes under. And we're just going to push our hips up and back. And our hands are going to remain shoulder width apart. Feet are shoulder, hip width apart. And you can keep a micro bend in the knees. A little bend in the knees. And we're going to push our weight back. Make sure the fingers are spread, and we're going to relax our head down and breathe here. So you're going to feel a nice deep stretch in the back of your legs. If you want, you can keep the knees micro bent at first, but if you're feeling okay, you can stretch them straight and breathe here. Head is relaxed. This is downward facing dog. We will be returning to this throughout your yoga journey. It's a beautiful pose. Try and straighten the knees now a little bit, feeling that stretch in the back of the legs, and bring your heels to the ground as much as possible. Good. Now let's look forward at the hands. And gently proceed to walk forward until the feet meet the hands. And it's okay if you can't touch. You're just going to remain here. If you're touching, that's fine. If not, take a hold of either elbow and again let your whole upper body hang down. Your head is relaxed. Again, we're working on stretching the back of those legs. Breathing long and deep in and out through the nose. You can play with micro-bending the knees and then straightening in the... and seeing really how deeply you can stretch the back of those legs. And then just relax your hands down. We're going to slowly ripple our way, unfolding one vertebrae at a time. All the way until we come to a standing position. So stay here for a moment. Feel your body nice and strong and straight. Tuck the tailbone under, chest open. Good. Now we're going to proceed by widening the legs. And I'm just going to turn so that I'm facing you, but you stay here. Widen the legs more than hip width apart. Put your hands on your hips. And then you're just going to proceed by taking nice, big circles with your hips. Nice big circles. Like there's a hula hoop around you and you're just scratching the edge of it with the hips. You should feel a nice stretch. Ooh, maybe you're feeling some cracking. That's perfectly okay. Switch directions. As slow as you need. Really feeling it. Ooh. Again, coming into presence and feeling this, trying to keep your mind into this moment. And we're going to come to center. We're going to bring our feet a little bit closer together. We're going to bring our hands out in front of us, interlace the fingers, cross the thumbs, and just point the pointer finger. And then we're going to just proceed to sit down in an imaginary chair. So this is for our thighs. Sit down a little lower. Tuck the tailbone under so you're not sticking your butt out too much. Sit down and breathe. We're here for 5 breaths. You can do it. Don't waver. Very, very slowly. We come up, we release the hands. I'm just gonna shake out the legs. Good, and now we're gonna widen the legs a little bit again. And we're gonna, if our knees are okay, we're gonna try this. If you have problems with your knees, just come to a seated pose on your seat. Otherwise, we're gonna just lower down really slowly into a squat. Use the upper arms and just open the legs. If this is too much, you just bring your hands behind you. That's fine. Or we're just going to take a few breaths here. And then we're going to come and sit down. So now we're going to just straighten our legs out in front of us. Point the toes towards the face. Inhale, stretch the arms up. Exhale, come forward. If you can touch the toes, that's great. If you can just touch the knees or the shins, that's fine. And then slowly start to fold down, and we're stretching the back of the legs again. Breathe here. The toes are pointed towards the face, and the spine is relatively straight, so we don't want to curl the spine. We want to try and keep that spine straight. We're here for a few breaths. I invite you to close your eyes and try and draw your inner gaze into the space between your eyebrows. And slowly you rise up. We're going to come to lying on our mat now. Bring the heels close to the seat, palms face down. See if you can tickle the heels with your fingers. Feet are hip width apart. And then we're going to inhale, pick the hips up. Exhale, bring them down. Bridge pose. Inhale. Try and keep the knees always the same distance apart, hip width apart. Come down. Inhale, come up. Exhale, come down. 3 more times, a little bit higher up every time. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. 1 more time. Inhale. Keep the hips up. Breathe a couple times here while the hips are up. Every breath, the hips come up higher. Breathe. And slowly lower down. Bring the knees into the chest. Give yourself a nice big hug and maybe rock from side to side. Massage out that spine. Good. Now we're going to bring the feet again. Place them on the ground. Knees are about hip width apart. You can take your hands like a cactus to the side of the body. And then we're just going to windshield wiper our knees, bringing them down to the left, coming to center, and then bringing them down to the right, feeling a nice twist in our spine. Going back and forth a few times. Going back to center, and now bringing your knees into your chest.
Giving yourself a nice big squeeze. Bring your head up so the forehead touches the knees. And squeeze. Squeeze everything. Squeeze your arms. Squeeze your face. Squeeze your glutes. Squeeze your toes. Squeeze everything. Squeeze every part of your body as tight as you can. For 5, 4, 3, 2, 1,
and then release and relax on your back in Shavasana, the final resting pose. So make sure your shoulders are nice and comfortable. The feet are about mat width apart. Toes are out to the side. Arms are out the side. Palms face up. So get nice and comfortable. If you're chilly, just bring a blanket. Cover yourself. We're going to rest now for some minutes. This is the most important pose of the whole practice. Take a moment, let your whole body integrate the entire experience. Give yourself permission to completely relax. Relaxing all parts of your body. Relaxing your feet, your ankles, your calves and shins, your knees, your thighs, your hips, your belly and back, your rib cage and chest, your shoulders, your arms, your head, and your mind. Everything relax. Night. Suggest everyone stay here for a minimum of 5 minutes. Thank you all so much for practicing, and I'll see you all soon. Namaste.